Okay, good morning. I got a quick video. I want to tell a story about a movie, one of my favorites of all time. When I was in the Navy in 1969, I was stationed at Lemoore Naval Air Station. I used to work on the A-70 Corsair, weapons, radars, all that stuff. But while there, I was around 19 or 20 when I met another young girl. She was 17 or 18, who lived in Fresno, which is 44 miles northeast of Lemoore Naval Air Station. My mom liked me, so she said I can come over anytime to get away from the base and all that sort of thing, which I liked. I got to eat civilian food. Well, I was over there one weekend, and had coming over, came over to TV to talk about this movie that's coming out that is going to be a TV series. But the movie back then, like even Route 66, for example, was kind of similar in methodology to this movie, except they had a Corvette traveling Route 66 around the country. It was a really good movie. You know, they would stop at different towns, they'd get into situations with people and help people out. Same with this movie. Bronson, Jim Bronson did the same thing. He would go in each episode, be in a different part of the country, and end up engaging people. And I like that because my personality is the same way. I ended up doing the same type of thing, even till now. Everybody, my wife, friends I work with, friends I just know as friends, they all say I talk to everybody, which I probably do. I'm a storyteller, I've written books, so I like to talk to people. That's how you learn things from people. You engage them. There's no one you can't learn something from, and there's no one you can't tell something to them that they don't know. So storytelling is a mutual exchange. And it's a good way to live life. You meet a lot of people and you can enjoy people. Well, this movie is so engaging to me because the real basic premise is that Bronson was a reporter and his friend committed suicide because all the stuff that was going on during the war, protest, gas lines around the block, kind of like this in some ways today. But the way he put the story together, Bonnie Bedelia is his woman interest by accident. And when I say by accident, she ran him off the road on Highway 1 by the Bixby Bridge, which is about 20 miles south of Carmel on Highway 1, if you're familiar with that. It's a real nice arching bridge. And in the beginning of the movie, you can see it going across there. And I've ridden my bike across there many times, especially after seeing the movie back then. I was a young guy. And it's just so interesting, the way he gets along. She runs him off the road, almost kills him. And he comes back and they get in a big fight and argument. All men and women know how that goes. And so because of her circumstance, which was she ran away from a wedding and the police were looking for her, and the police showed up at this one location. She pretended she knew him, and he went along with it, even though she almost killed him. And they start traveling together on a Sportster. Her personality was, she comes from a family of privilege. Bronson was a working man, a reporter. And the way they deal with each other is no different than the way people deal with each other today. It was just more of a expose of personalities, this type versus this type. And even though they don't realize they're starting to go together, falling in love, they still go through all of that stuff that everybody at one time or another probably has went through. It really touches the person. And the motorcycle part is doing the trip. That's what he ends up doing in all these episodes. He would go to different towns, meet different people, talk to them, end up helping them, solving problems. You know, I've done that myself on the road with the bike and as a cop for 25 years. But things were different then. I'll give you one quick example. A friend of mine died when I was in the Navy, when this movie, that time period was going on. He was going a cross-country trip back home in Massachusetts, went off the road and hit a boulder. Some people say he fell asleep. Well, that upset me so much. It was the first time they came out with a four-cylinder Honda 750. I ended up buying the same bike, different color. And I said, I'm going to finish the trip. So I made a trip back to Pennsylvania. It was my first cross-country trip, which led me to constant riding and trips. I've ridden a motorcycle in 47 states, including Hawaii and Alaska. So I've been to a lot of trips, talked to a lot of people. I'm talking about farmers in the middle of nowhere. Well, it's just, farmers in the middle of flyover country for most yuppies. We have talked to people who are nuclear engineers. They ride freezing horses, and she's a beautiful lady. I mean, it's just a part of my nature. My family's like that. I had nine uncles and aunts, and our family always talked to everybody. Everybody was always friendly, and I've been the same way. I've been to South Africa during apartheid, and if they would have known I was Swedish, I probably would have been in trouble, because they had to tell some non-truths on the paperwork to even get in, because they didn't let Swedes like me into South Africa during apartheid. But I just like talking to people and getting things done. I mean, what I like here, but it's apartheid. I'm Swedish, right? That's how, fun life can be if you're trying to bounce around, travel, see things. Because everybody has a different perspective. How far you can see depends on how high up the mountain you are. So, it's a very enjoyable movie. It's not a Hallmark movie. It doesn't go that far. It's more realistic. Bronson's kind of the cool guy, the 60s cool guy. Not the cool guys they have today. I mean, the real cool guy, James Dean, Bronson, that caliber of coolness. And if you are a youngster, never been around the 60s, if you watch this, it immerse you in a little bit of 60s behavior. The way that they talk, what words they use, because language evolves just like people do. And so watching this, you'll get to see what the 60s were like. Everything from the cars to the behaviors to the choices they make when problems come up. So, if you want to go back in the time machine, the 60s, especially if you ride bikes. You don't have to ride bikes. You can have an old truck and do the same thing. But this will be your ticket, your time machine, back to those days. I love those days. I had four different new motorcycles when I was in the Navy. I was always switching bikes, switching girlfriends. That sort of thing. You gotta keep moving, right? That's what keeps me so young. A 29-year-old Swede, that's me. So I hope you enjoy the video. I'll put a couple pictures from the movie. And I'm telling you, this is a good movie. You watch this, you'll feel better when it's over.